Maybe it's time for you to create your own first dashboard. You do that by going to the File menu and select the New option. Also, you need to select a template, and for this one we just go with a standard blank dashboard template. That will bring up an empty canvas like this, and from the Design menu we can now add a new crosstab. This empty crosstab needs to be filled in by source data. We're looking at the TARGIT online demo database and the sales cube with these dimensions and these measures. You can click the cube itself to change to a different cube, for instance the finance cube with some other dimensions and other measures. But let's go back to the sales cube, and since this is a sales cube, let's add a revenue measure. Just click it. And also from my item dimension here, we got several options here, but we got a hierarchy, this one here with two levels, and let's just add the first level here, item group, to our crosstab as well. Just click it and then use this button, the fetch button, to fetch your data. And since it was a hierarchy, we could use this button to expand to the next level. And then maybe a little bit of resizing of this crosstab. Maybe we should just put it there. Let's add a second crosstab. And this crosstab, we will also like to look at revenue again, but together with profit and profit margin. So now we got three measures in this crosstab, as you can see here. And now we will use the salesperson dimension, the salesperson name attribute, this one. And again, let's just fetch data. So that was a second crosstab. You can use this blue handle to move your crosstabs, maybe using the guides, and again a little bit of resizing for this one. Let's add a third crosstab to this dashboard, and for this one we'll be looking into revenue, and then by my customer dimension we got some customer territories, and notice it goes on the vertical axis here. And I'm going to add a second dimension as well, my year dimension, and notice this one on the horizontal axis. So when I fetch data here, it will initially look like this, and we can go and use this option maximize just to focus on the single crosstab, but we can clearly see the two dimensions on each axis here. If I go into define mode, I can drag and drop my dimensions, so if I want to swap the two dimensions, I get a presentation like this. It's the exact same numbers, just a different presentation. And again, I could also go here and choose to put both dimensions on the vertical axis like this to get a result like that. Alright, let's restore this crosstab back to the dashboard right there, and maybe a bit of resizing. And now let's go and add a fourth object, but this time a chart, not a crosstab, but actually a column chart. And I want to look into revenue again, and also by my time dimension, but this time the year, month, date hierarchy. We see the three levels of the hierarchy here, and I simply pick the month level. And when I fetch data, we get a column chart like this. Let's just put it down here where we can see it like this, and here we can easily see that we're looking at 4 years of data, 48 months of data. Now if I make sure to select my column chart again, I can now go to my source data and pick another dimension, for instance the customer territory. It's the same dimension used in the crosstab with Asia, Europe and North America. And when I select it from my column chart, you can see that it becomes three series of data in the chart. Before saving this dashboard, I would like to move to my dimensions over here, into my period dimension. If I right click this year, month, date hierarchy, I have an option here to add it to criteria bar. When I do that, it appears up here and you can use that as a filter. You can add as many dimensions as you like, for instance the company dimension as well, and you can see the drop downs, the filtering options for each of those dimensions up there. Let's just turn it into consumer mode with this button here, and maybe also we'd like to hide the panel on the left hand side, hide the smart pad. So now we can start using this as a consumer user. We can filter it to 2020 with the drop down from the criteria bar. We can do a drill down on a specific item here. We can remove the drill down. We can do a drill down on a salesperson, etc. All right, so maybe it's time to save it. So file, save as. Should it go into your shared folder or one of the subfolders that you see here? Or would you rather like to click here on the root to put it into your personal folder? Let's pick the personal folder and give it a proper name, my first dashboard, and then save it. And that's it. That's been saved as my first dashboard in your personal folder.